Winter was passing, but there was still one or two late fronts, which made everything look sugar-coated and sparkling in the spring sunshine. As the months had passed, the other engines had become quite used to being the express and making the journey between the big station and London. Each morning, Donald and Douglas took it in turns to bring a ballast train from the small railway, and then another engine would pull the trucks into a place where the line was being mended. One morning, Donald was uncoupled and ran ahead into a sort siding to let James take his place at the front of the truck, but a hard frost had made the rails icy. When Donald tried to stop, his wheels locked and they slid on the ice. Before he could say fat controller, he hit the buffers at the end of the siding. The buffers had stopped him, but they were badly damaged. And the other engines teased him. "You should go for an ice skating championship," they said. Even Donald laughed, though he was worried what the fat controller might say. But the fat controller only warned him to be more careful. He knew it hadn't really been Donald's fault. The next day, men were sent to mend the buffers. At last, repair work on the line was ending. "Tomorrow's train, Douglas, will be the last for the time being," the fat controller told him. The next day, Douglas was putting his truck into a siding. "Here are your trucks, Henry. What are you going to do now that the job is finishing?"
"Pull some passenger trains, I hope. I'm tired of doing the same thing all the time."
"Never mind, there's the last one."
Douglas puffed slowly onto the short siding. At the end of the siding, the men who had been mending the buffers were standing side to side. They had pots of paint beside them and had just finished painting the buffer bar bright red. And as Douglas moved into the siding, his driver put on the brakes, but nothing happened. Douglas smashed into the buffers. The workmen watched in dismay. Douglas rolled steadily along the line and smashed to splinters the buffers they had just spent 3 days mending.
"Ouch!" exclaimed Douglas, opening his eyes. "That hurt!"
The new buffers had stopped him, but unfortunately, Douglas had been moving faster than Donald. He was in a terrible mess. His front was badly bent and he was smeared with the bright red paint, which hadn't had time to dry.
"Silly great engine," scolded the foreman, waving his paintbrush angrily. It still had red paint on it, and some of the paint flew out and stuck on Douglas's nose. "3 days' work," the foreman said crossly, "and in 3 seconds you come in and smash it all to pieces." "How is it my fault that my brakes failed? You're acting like I did this on purpose, when I had no control over this." "I don't care. The fat controller will be hearing about this."
Douglas's front wheels were off the rails, so James had to come and rescue him. "Douglas, this accident wasn't your fault, and it seems that lately your brakes haven't been working, so you shall go to the works to have your buffers mended and you'll get new brakes."
"Thank you, sir,"